Let's talk more about why people might have trust issues in romantic relationships and how this is related to food. A child is completely dependent on his mother during the first year of his life. His mother is his world. This is the stage when a child is learning on a cellular level if they can trust other people or not. His mother is the representation of all people and the outside world itself. The foundation of trust is being built when a baby feels his mother's body while she is breastfeeding him or just holding him in her arms. If a mother abandoned her child or a baby was separated from the mother because of medical reasons, they cannot develop healthy physical contact. Instead, they experience what is called in psychology abandonment trauma. This child will likely have trust issues when they grow up. Let me share with you my personal story. I was born in Russia. When I was born, babies were separated from their mothers immediately after birth. All newborns were taken to a separate room. They were spent several days in their own tiny beds and were given to their mothers only for feeding. There were only a couple nurses taking care of 10 to 15 babies at once. Of course, these babies did not receive enough love and care. Every baby had a tag that helped the nurses to identify their mothers. Later in my life, my mom told me a story about that one day a nurse brought me for feeding to another woman by mistake. In the United States, the paid maternity leave is very short. Most women must come back to their job within 12 weeks to keep their position. 12 weeks is about 3.5 months. This is not enough for mother-child bonding. When mother goes to work, many newborns can experience emotional abandonment by their mothers. Fathers, grandparents, nannies, and preschool can only partially replace the mother's love. As a result, we have lots of women and men who have problems with commitment. We don't trust each other. We are afraid to be vulnerable. We don't feel safe to express our true emotions and feelings. In the United States, about 35% of adults are diagnosed with obesity. Food is one of the easiest ways to suppress our emotions. Let's talk a little bit more about the importance of mother-child emotional bonding and how it is related to food. Most of you have probably heard about postpartum depression, a condition where mothers cannot take care of their babies for several days, sometimes weeks and even months. This can create abandonment trauma in a child's psyche. The first emotional contact is a reciprocal smile which happens between the first and second month of a baby's life. If the mother shows her emotional connection with the baby, then the child develops a sense of love and security. Love and security are two most important things for every baby to experience in order for him to create a healthy psyche. The first conscious anxiety of the absence of the mother develops around at the age of 7 months, and conscious fear of strangers develops at 8 months. This is another important period when mother should be very careful when she leaves her baby with a nanny, grandparents, or at a preschool. This should be a process of gradual and safe separation. A baby must learn that his mom is always coming back. The mother should start with a small window of separation and gradually increase it. On average, 7 to 9 months old babies are extremely sensitive to the development of any type of anxiety, stress, and fear. At this age, we form three important beliefs that will impact the rest of our lives. 1. The world is a safe place to live, or the world is a dangerous place to live. 2. I can trust people, or I cannot trust people because they might abandon me. 3. The world is an abundant place, or the world has limited resources. If a baby had a limited amount of emotional contact with his mother during the first year of his life, then there is a high chance that this child will develop a trust issue growing up.